As of now, they are and don't be specific with this COX-A, XR or XM because the name just given it. Okay. Now, if you want about processor, they will tell we are not aware of that one. So, processor, they are aware only with respect to the number, which is ARM7, ARM9 and ARM11. They are the three processors which are in the market presently available. Okay, so these are the things which are present. So first processor, we were trying to identify the instruction set. Okay, so ARM, different types of ARM configuration, the ARM Cortex family. So Cortex A series designed for high performance open application. R series designed for high-end embedded system in real-time performance as needed, and M series designed for deeply embedded microcontroller types of a system. So these are the which is available. Still more information it is not given because our aim is here is to make you understand the how many what are the architecture available and also at architecture available, what are the instruction set present, what are the different types of instruction set available, and use those things, how we need to program. Obviously, programs are there for your lab also, so that you will still more be familiar with this embedded system. Okay, so this is also one of the core languages which you should be familiar of. Okay, apart from HDL, apart from C language, apart from VLSI, this is one more language, microcontroller. This is one more, which is the ARM.
Sir, go back to the previous slides and explain, sir, as there was no synchronization in the previous class.
Just a presentation here, though.
Yes,
sir. It is not in detail or what you call completely, and examination also they will be ask you to write the Cortex 3 processor, then type with their specification. Okay, still we have not got into depth of that, still it is starting. We inform you, you need to download the series application processors designed to handle complex applications such as high-end embedded operating system. These require highest power virtual memory system support with memory management. Right. Then when it comes to the R profile, when it comes to the R profile, which is a real-time profile, we're suitable for those applications such as high-end brain system and hard drive controller in which high processing powers and high reliability are essential for and for which low latency is important. So this classification, right, it is not only limited to the parts which we're using for the real-time application, like refrigerator, washing machine gadgets. The processor can be for any of the system where you have multiple peripherals attached to the processor. Okay, it can be a vehicle. Vehicle we are having with multiple peripherals. Right, that is also one part. What we call a projector, video conferencing. So those examples are the for the A part, R part, as well as the M part, the machine, the Cortex family. So different types of architecture are there. So again, it depends on the application with respect to the data set to that. So for any of the processor you observe, there is a instruction manual added along with that one. Right? The architecture they will provide, instruction they will provide, and all those things they will be added to the processor that will be given, right? When you do your projects also, embedded board, the ARM board, microcontroller board, or the we call the one more board, it is there, which you'll be using for the so board also will be having the instruction set. So it is mandatory you need to provide those things. So you can observe this is a evolution of ARM processor architecture, right? So we can see, observe your architecture, right? Version 4, where ARM 7TD MI 920 Intel strong ARM. So these are the examples. So period of time it is gradually increasing, right? Version 5, 6 and version 7. So till version 7, these products were not released. They were released only for the research purpose, which we cannot get in the real time. Now in the market, if we go and ask for this, these boards will be not available. Okay, this is just the part. So in each of these processor, what are the peripherals added, right? So those things we need to observe. So for architecture 5, you can observe Intel X-Scale. For architecture 6, you can observe this is a Cortex which has been added with this architecture. And finally, for the architecture 7, we are having A, R and M, right? Application, real-time microcontroller. The board used are Cortex-A8, Cortex-R4 and Cortex-M3, right? So this is where we are working. Evolution of ARM processor architecture, right? Then after ARM 7, it was released ARM 9, then ARM 11. So you can see the Cortex version, how it has been evolving. M02, now we have A15, right? This is only general information about you, how this processor keep on increasing over a period of time. That will be similar to your Moore's law. For every 18 months, your components will be doubled, right? So here also the processor usage also, it is gradually increasing. Now next it comes with respect to the instruction set development. So historically, since ARM 7TDMA, two different instruction sets are supported for the ARM processor. So in the architecture also, I was highlighting this only. So instruction set, it supports two types. First types, we call it as a normal ARM instruction that are of 32 bits. And there is one more instruction which we call it as a thumb instruction, right? That are of 16 bit. Okay, that are of 16 bits. This is only for classification. Why we do classify these two types? The reason being only that still it should be easy for the user. Okay, because if I build a processor and that processor, if it has been released in the right, so other users will try to buy my product and they want to implement their application. So they should understand how my processor will work. So I should write an instruction set for that. So tell them these are the instructions, these are the commands, this is how you need to use, then it will work. Okay. So to give this one, again instruction manual we will be giving for them, and to clearly make them understand. So what we do, again we classified this ARM 7 into two types of instructions. One is of length 16 bits and one is of length 32 bits. Okay, this is all only for making ease to write a program. That is the only intention here, right? We want to make things simpler. We don't want to make things complex. That is the only reason. So during program execution, the processor can be dynamically switched between the ARM state and the thumb state to use either one of the instruction set. The thumb instruction set provides only a subset of ARM instruction, but it can provide higher code density. It is useful for products with tight memory requirements. Right. So we will be having two types of memory. One is ROM, One is RAM. So ROM it is only for the read only memory, and random access memory it is for the temporary type of memory. So what happens in the ROM and RAM? One few example what I can share to you is that I want to transmit a message, or I want to send a message or transmit a data to the receiver. So what I have to do is that I have to type those numbers, put all message content, and I need to send. Once it has been sent, still that message, till it reaches to the destination, copy of message it should retain. Okay, why it has to retain this? Because we should know that our message has been reached destination or not. Okay, so for this one, what usually we do is that, so we will send in WhatsApp. So I have sent message to my friend. So my friend has received that message. Okay, but still he has not. So that information, how I will come to know? So I will see whether that tick mark is there or not. That blue color tick marks, if it comes, so I will understand that the receiver has read my messages. If there is no blue tick mark, if it is a gray tick mark, then understand that my message delivered, but still has not read. Okay, so these are the few things. Okay, so why we have to retain those messages? Because we are transmitting messages in a channel, and in the channel that message may be a possibility it may lose. Okay, 99% it will not lose, but sometimes it may lose. Then what happens? I need to resend that message. So resend means again I cannot regenerate what I have transmitted. So that is why we will retain one copy, right? And we need to resend it again. This we will do usually in mail also. We will tell that it will be in the draft reason. So how best you are going to use this memory part, right? So that part also it is given for the thumb set and as well as ARM instruction part. So one by one instructions we are going to observe here, then it will be very clear for all of you. As an architecture version has been updated, extra instructions have been added to both ARM instruction and thumb instruction. In 2003, ARM announced the thumb 2 instruction set, which is new superset of thumb instruction that contains both 16-bit and has a 32-bit instruction. So now what are the things which we observed is that is telling that you can prepare your own processor on your own. Okay, no need for buying the processor outside also. Right? So I want to build my own processor. So what is the procedure for that one? So what I have to do for my own processor, I require one memory. So I need to purchase that one. I need while I'm control bus, what are the control actions which I need to take? What is the database I need to take? What is the memory operation which I need to take? Which is the I/O operation which I need to take? And combine these things, I need to build a processor. Right? Now my processor, if I think that it is a projector. So for projector, I require a display thing and I require a power button. I don't require any of the memory things. So display LCD display program, if I write switch on and switch off power code for that one, that is sufficient. Then I can build a simple processor for that one. I'm writing a code, what I need to do when this power is on, LCD display should be on, and whatever keypad input will be there, that should be displayed. So this is simple example of what we are given to build a processor. Right? Now for this processor, I need to keep on adding the peripherals, like remote I need to do, like extra addition I need to do. So for all those things, I need to write out each for which I need to write out the instruction names. Right? Like moving a data, I should give a command move. Now adding a data, I should give add. I want to store a data, I need to do that one. I need to read the data, for that one I need to give command. I want to write the data, for that one I need to give a command. And these things I need to write up in a instruction set, and that I should provide it along with my processor. So how you are going to do those things is cleanly explaining step by step. So you can observe that instruction set So again, now why the trend is that now at this present, at this moment, these many instructions are sufficient. But in future, I want to add few more things. So for that also, my processor should support it. Now my instructions are so many, I should do only this much. It is not the case. Okay, I can add few more and I can delete few more, and that support it should also provide. No, it will not provide these kind of operations, means then that device or that processor nobody will purchase. Okay, now finally what we have to do is that we need to market our product and we need to sell our processor. Selling our processor based on the requirement of the user. Right, this is all with respect to the technical engineer which you are preparing the processor. You are not at the buyer side, you are not at the customer side. Customer side requirements you need to take, and you need to build a processor and you need to sell it. That is a thing which you need to observe here. Right. The next thing is that the thumb to technology and instruction set architecture. So now he is telling that how you need to build your instruction set based on the architecture. So the thumb to technology extended the thumb instruction set architecture ISA into a highly efficient and powerful instruction set that delivers significant benefits in terms of ease of use, code size and performance. Okay, so previous semester we had written one same full adder program in multiple ways, in data flow, in behavioral, in structural, right? In many ways we had written. We had written code in 4 line, we had written code in 8 line, we have written code in 1 line also. That is the power with respect to this instruction set. And if you are well versed of this instruction set, then you can write your code in a compact way, producing 100% efficiency, which is your high performance result. Okay, that is the main agenda here. The extended instruction set in thumb 2 is a superset of the previous 16-bit thumb set with additional 16-bit instruction set along with 32-bit instruction. It allows more complex operation to be carried out in the thumb set, thus allowing higher efficiency by reducing the number of state switching between ARM state and thumb state. This is the work which we will be doing. Right, it is just like a function. Right, so I want to pass on information to all the students of 6th A. Okay, so I want to pass on information, so I need to make one message, group message there, and send in group. In that group also, how many will be viewing, how many will be not viewing, I will be not aware. So what I will do, I need to put one Google form and I need to ask you to submit this form. So how many people will be submitted, from that I will come to know how many people have viewed my messages. Right, so for everything you should be cross verifying whether it is correct or not. Right, and then only it will be a success, then only you can see whether your processor is having high efficiency or not. Right. So this is the architecture view. Right, so thumb 2 technology, it comprises of 32-bit and 16-bit, then you have Cortex-3, then we have thumb instruction. Right, so this is overlapping of these things, and this is provided in the ARM7 machine architecture. So the relationship between a thumb instruction set in thumb 2 technology and traditional thumb is of this one. Now this thumb instructions meant was normal instruction type which requires 16 bits information. Okay, now 16 bit information means you will be having 2 register with 1 command. Suppose say move A comma B, we call that as a 16 bit information. Add A. Okay, so A register is adding with the accumulator, so 16 bit. Rotate A. Okay, so it is a 8 bit instruction. Right, so you will be knowing what is a cycle. Okay, in microcontroller and microprocessor, they will be telling what is the how many instruction cycle it will tell. So if I write initialize A and B, initialize A equal to 5, initialize B equal to 10, then I will write move A comma B. right, then end it. So this is a program which I have written. So with this program, what is the response type? Okay, I will ask, what is the response type? Now response time, how we are going to calculate is for a particular instruction. So I need to write initialize A. So for that one cycle is required. Initialize B, so two cycle is required. So one cycle, I will tell it as 1 millisecond. So two cycles means 2 millisecond. Okay, then move A comma B. So whatever A value is there, it should be moved to B. And doing this, he will call A register, he will call B register, and he is moving A and B. So what happens? He is calling A and moving A to B. So two cycles are required. So initializing and all those things, around 5 cycles. So 5 millisecond is the time required for processing this operation. Is it or no? So with this operation, 5 millisecond is taken. So you will get output after 5 millisecond. So now if I give input A and B, after 5 seconds, my A value will be moved to B using this instruction set. That is the thing here. Now here all it is taking A and B. If I initialize A equal to 5, B equal to 10 in one line. So it is taking 1 cycle. I can reduce this one. So that possibility will be provided by this ARM7 also. That is the meaning here which is trying to tell. So earlier thumb instruction, the fixed length was 16 bit. Now in this thumb 2 instruction, 16 bit information also can be taken. Along with that one, 32 bit instruction also can be taken. That is the advantage over here. The thumb 2 instruction set architecture supports only 2 instruction set. Instead of using ARM instruction for some operation as in traditional ARM processor, it uses the thumb 2 instruction set for all operation. So obviously this is all theory bit about the instruction part which we are discussing. When we take one example, one application of that one, how to move the data, what is the instruction values, when we keep on reading that one, then it will be all easy for you people to understand that how it has been done. With support of for both 16 bit and 32 bit instruction, there is no need to switch processor between thumb state. Now you are switching this state also indicating that it will take some amount of time, it will be latency will be delayed. That is the meaning here. Right. So now we go for the applications of this Cortex M3 processor. See, first module, it deals with the processor types, application, different values, right? Then when we start with the instruction set value, then you will try to understand. It was just like similar to your SGL what we have learned. In SGL also we started with learning the basics, then we were writing programs for the means instruction giving to you the programs. So still we have not reached to the writing to the programming level. In the next class, I will take one program level and try to explain to you how we need to code, go about programming about the embedded system. Okay, this is just about the Cortex processor and its features and its application. Okay, so if I give one device to you, you should know about that one. Now here the device is with respect to the Cortex M3 processor. So for that one, what is limitation, what is the application, those things we are just going to rewind that one, right? So we are using low cost microcontroller, ideal suited this application consumer, right? So if I take toys, right, it will rotate, it will move forward, it will move backward. So that is the only operation, the rotate 360 degree. So LEDs will be on, right? LED pattern, it will be in some odd numbering or even numbering. So there are many types of thing. So you can add movement with respect to this motor, stepper motor or DC motor. So it will move forward, it will move backward, it will move right, it will move left. That is one type of processor application we can have. Second type of application, it can be with respect to the LED lights glowing. So odd number, it should glow. Even number, it should glow. So concurrently, it should go on off, it should do. On period, it should be 5 seconds. Off period, it should be 2 seconds. So there are multiple ways which we can write program. Right. So this is one more thing which is LED on and off. Then we can have toys with when we press one button, so one particular thing should arrive. One particular switch, one more thing we should get. So if you open the toys inside, that also we call it as a processor. Right. And that work it is only that when you give a power to that one, it will be active and it will work. Right, maybe birthday candles also. So you'll get that flower type. So when it is means when you burn that one with a matchstick, right? So happy birthday ring will come. Right. So that is also a processor which we can add. For that one, the cost will be how much? Around 10 to 15 rupees. That's all. So one ringtone music which has been added, and that will be connected to one power supply for which battery which you have given. That battery cost is around 5 to 10 rupees. So when on, so ringtone it will generate. So that we call also a processor, which is a cost processor. For that product we are paying around 80 rupees. Cost of generating that plastic will be around 10 to 15 rupees. Battery around 5 to 10 rupees, and writing that code and for the hardware it will be around 10 to 15 rupees. So the cost of that product will be 25 rupees, and we are paying around 80 rupees. That thing we only can do, right? So this is the meaning. Means I am saying there are simple programs which you can write it and which you can manufacture as a product. Don't require use. That is why we will tell that I am not asking you to make a to build a mobile phone. I can ask you to do. I can't tell you build one application for laptop, right? That is completely small things. LED should be on, LED off, water tank monitoring. So water reaches to one level, so LED motor should be off. So these are all application of this processor, right? So these are low cost microcontroller. Next it is low. High performance, ease of use, 32 migrator system architecture. So these are all examples of low cost microcontroller. Next set of application, it is with respect to the automotive. So automotive, you can see here very high performance efficiency and low interrupt latency. So you may observe that petrol tank, right? What a petrol tank level it is indicating. So whether the tank is full or not. How much it is, means what is the capacity there, how much it is full, everything information it will give, right? And when there is a low petrol, right, in the vehicle, so it will indicate by LEDs telling that you are low on petrol, kindly fill it, right? So those are all applications of this processor, right? I am taking examples of this toys, taking examples of this automotive. So these processors only we should understand. And once we are familiar with all those six, then we can go for the high-end gadgets. Okay. So these are example of an automotive. Then data communication. The processor, lower power and high efficiency coupled with instruction in thumb two for communication applications such as Bluetooth and Zigbee. Right. So we have seen Bluetooth application. We have seen Zigbee application, where processor will need to connect with two devices which are far away, right? So from Bluetooth it needs to be connected. So these are the application of the processor. So processor should be observing with what range your two devices are. Now what happens is that in your mobile phone Bluetooth is there, your friend mobile phone Bluetooth is there, you both sit side by side, Bluetooth on, share video or share photo, Bluetooth connected, Bluetooth paired, Bluetooth sent, Bluetooth you have received the data, right? So this part you know, Right, this part normal lay person also will know. Right, if you ask for your parents also, how you are going to send one type of data from this mobile to other mobile. So you will tell that you can use Bluetooth. So that a normal layman also will see. Right, but how that Bluetooth is evolved. So you should understand what is the processor there, whether that processor support this Bluetooth architecture. So Bluetooth architecture, you should understand it is with respect to the range, and that range, that device should be present. You identify that device, you need to set up, you need to pair that device, then you need to transmit that device. So these all things you should be able to do, then only you are able to transmit the data to the destination. So these are the few things which will be present. Next, when we go to the industrial application, like simplicity, fast response, reliability, key factors. So you can observe that in the industry level, the impact will be very huge. So if anything once goes wrong, then complete system will be gone. So there will be a huge loss, because they will be producing n number of products, and one it is malfunction, then completely it will be gone. So these are few examples which is there. Then consumer products, right? So this is all what we will be experiencing. In many consumer product, a high performance microprocessor is used, like your mobile phone, like your television, like your refrigerator, like your microwave oven, like your air conditioning. So all these are gadgets where multiple peripherals are added to do a specific application to get the resulted output. Right, so we will not open laptop and see what components are there. We will not open air condition and see what options are there. Right, why? Because those are all high end processor. So if we make any mistakes, it will not listen to us. That is the problem. Why we fear to open these devices? Because if we put one bit into another bit, it will not respond. It is all processor. So processor means it will check whether it is zero, whether it is one, whether it is short circuit, whether it is open circuit. If it is open circuit and you are expecting a result, means if lifelong, if you wait also, you will not get result. Right. So you need to understand the processor in a better way. Okay. Then discuss about the advantages of Cortex M3 processor. So you have low power consumption, enhanced determination, greater performance efficiency, improved code density, ease of use, lower cost solution, wide choice of development tools. Right. So these are the advantages of a Cortex M3 processor. Right. So